Requirements to enter Ukraine, all you have to know and do. The Ukrainian government has lifted the entry ban for foreign citizens on June 15. The resolution number 480 of the Cabinet of Ministers of Ukraine, CMU, stipulates that foreign citizens arriving from countries with a high spread of COVID-19, i.e., red countries with 40-plus people per 100,000 population, has to demonstrate to have medical insurance covering all expenses related to COVID-19 treatment while on the territory of Ukraine. List of countries last updated June 17 in the description below. Curiously, since the list was created back on June 14, Ukraine became as well a red country as by its standards. These countries' lists will be provided to the State Border Guard Service of Ukraine every 3 days by the Ministry of Health of Ukraine. Named as current data on COVID-19, the list can be found on the Ministry of Social Health of Ukraine. https://moz.gov.ua/coronavirus2019/cough, foreign citizens entering Ukraine will have to comply with sanitary and epidemiological norms. They will be required to enter into mandatory isolation in a government clinic or assume self-quarantine at a given address, your destination in Ukraine. Unless if arriving in Ukraine from a green country where the foreign citizen stayed for a minimum of 14 days. Persons who agreed to self-isolation using the electronic service, DIY VDOMA, are not obliged to isolation at a government clinic. Current practice for all arriving persons, citizens of Ukraine or foreigners, citizens of countries with a high prevalence of COVID-19, red, have not been on the territory of these countries during the last 14 days if there is no reason to believe they were in contact with a person with COVID-19 or not subject to observation. Act at Home app was launched to counteract the spread of COVID-19 in Ukraine. How can I get a valid medical insurance for Ukrainian authorities covering COVID-19? As far as per reported experiences entering Ukraine, nationals and holders of permanent or temporary residence permits are not being asked for medical insurance as the residence process already obliged to have it. Regarding foreign travelers traveling to Ukraine for tourism, it turns to be a must-have. Several Ukrainian insurance companies are selling those specific COVID-19 policies. They are quite inexpensive and possible to acquire online. Coronavirus insurance online in 5 minutes. Prices from up to $2.20 per day covering for any period, from 1 to 180 days. It is not as much believing as it may fully cover all your medical assistance needs if required to activate such insurance, but suitable for crossing the border and meet the requirements of the decree of the Cabinet of Ministers of Ukraine number 480 of June 12, 2020. The policy covers the costs of treatment with COVID-19 and observation as required by border guards, payment by a credit/debit card of any bank in the world on the site. The policy instantly comes to your email with a seal and signature. Important to note that such policies turn valid only 15 days after the purchasing date, so it is imperative to proceed timely. Unfortunately, the overwhelming majority of these companies do not speak English or have the language option on their websites. But I will be glad to assist any of my friends and clients to arrive and stay in Ukraine as required by law. How to self-isolate using the state electronic app service, DIY VDOMA? Based on reports from foreign citizens landing in Ukraine and locals, I had the opportunity to receive and assist at arrival in Borispol. This is the process at entry. No one is allowed to leave the plane or pass the airport gate without having the app installed. As citizens can only install the app with Ukrainian phone numbers, plus 380, a local SIM card is given free of charge with unlimited internet for the time of quarantine, and the immigration services at the airport will make sure that you have it properly running. Info source in the description below, the app displays your cell number at the top, the IS recorded along with all your data and destination address. Then, you are ready to go to customs. You'll have 24 hours to get to your place of residence, and the app continually reminds you to activate it once you arrive at your destination, where you'll be in quarantine. Plus minus 3 times a day, the app sends you a message that opens your mobile and asks you to take a selfie. The app uses your GPS and photo to determine you are at the given address. Once the app accepts your photo, you may have to shoot more than once, as not always the app succeeds in identifying you, and you will be prompt to take another photo within up to 15 minutes, you are then authenticated and within the law requirements. The screen will show the number of days left for your isolation period. After the last day, it sends a notification that you have complied with the rules, claims it deleted all your data from the server and can exit the app and dislocate within the country at your own will. If failing to comply with this procedure on, timely take the selfie and upload it to the app from geolocation matching your given address, the local police will physically check you at the given address. The fine for non-compliance will be 17,000 Ukrainian hryvnia, $632, per each time you'll not be found at your address, risking being ordered to fulfill the remaining quarantine time at a designated government clinic. The Ukrainian government is taking this seriously as open the borders and simultaneously contain the spread of the virus is not an easy task but necessary to help the economy grows and somehow satisfy everyone's desires. If you are reasonably complying with the rules, local police will not disturb you just for being a foreigner in Ukraine. A brilliant example of how a state and a smartphone modernizes Ukraine. As only 10-15% of people traveling abroad do not have smartphones, as stated by the Minister of Infrastructure. For personalized in-country support, contact us at info@fading.com.